The man who works so hard for pole position is stationary. The leader is sure enough. Keke Rosberg with in second position, one of the JPS cars. Theo Carvey is in third position, so he did have a good start. Rosberg leading. Senna and Prost together as they go down to Tarzan for the sixth time. Lauda passes Carvey and goes up into fourth position. Niki Lauda is another driver who reckons he's got something to prove in this race, to prove that he's still a winner, notwithstanding his decision, which he took in Austria, to retire at the end of this year after one of the most successful Grand Prix careers of all time. That is Stefan Johansson, with the Ferrari smoking badly. Stefan Johansson, who is in 11th position, looks as though he's in trouble and he's going out of the race. And the popular trouble in Grand Prix racing these days, turbo expiring, has hit Stefan Johansson.
That's obvious, trying to fall into that Valbretto. Has he got the straight line speed? He's perfectly placed as they come onto the straight. He's got a nice toe there. Alvaretto's making the hole in the air, and here he comes. He's moved out. He's taking. Alvaretto has not shut the door down the inside, and that looks like Tombe. Moving up as the ninth place, and a bit of punishment. Alvaretto knocked his brakes then, but all is well. And that looks like Keke Rosberg in trouble.
So, Keke Rosberg has done what we feared he would do on lap 21 out of 17 after a stirring drive. And Prost and Lauda is into the pits and now away.
Yes, and it's tired. So everybody, we've had two of them stop already in the car. Yes, this is the first reset, Lauda had a set. So what has obviously happened is that Goodyear's guesses about what compound was going to work today, because as I said earlier, it was only guesswork, obviously hasn't paid off.
Prost has got the race in his pocket yet again, but he's probably got to come in for time. Fourth and fifth, Sura with the orange helmet and the white and blue Brabham, with Ayrton Senna coming out from behind his rear wing, up to pass the Brabham on braking into Tarzan, which they started braking for at some 200 miles an hour. Into the pits now comes Alain Prost. This is the race leader, and now that should mean that Niki Lauda will get very close to him indeed, with the seconds ticking away, and you can see that the brake pads of the left front wheel are smoking and the right front. And 18.3 seconds, a slow pit stop.
Prost this time looks pretty well pasted. I think it could do with being about a length closer if he could, but he's going to get the draft. Yes, Prost is well pasted.
And goes through indeed to take that second place, and the gap now between Niki Lauda and the race leader and the new second place man that you're looking at, appropriately number two, Alain Prost, is 10.7 seconds on lap 48. Two laps to go at the end of this one. Alain Prost has not finished lower than third this year, an incredible situation. And Prost is now, as you see, right up. My goodness.
Yes, Prost trying to do a bit of opportunism there. He actually risked it on the grass. He saw he knocked the slippery grass, the left side of the car up, and start back onto the track. But that was just the sort of situation that Prost was looking for. This is probably the last chance for Prost, close enough to get a good toe down the straight. I suppose if you've seen him, they will now really need a mistake from Lauda to give Prost the chance. Lauda can drive defensively all the way around the last lap and just fend Alain Prost off. I don't think we'll see Prost doing anything over heroic. He's either off for 6 points than Lauda. I'm sure that will be other ways to decide. But what a tremendous dice between